Hey everybody, welcome back to The Witcher 3. So we're now looking for Hammond, and if you don't remember who Hammond is, he's somebody connected to Lambert here. So where is it here? Taking care of Gherkin, now talk to Lambert. It turned out he was hunting for people responsible for the death of his friend, Aiden, a witcher from the Cat School. Lambert had learned Aiden had been murdered by a gang of hired thugs led by a man named Jad Carradine. Geralt decided to help Lambert, and the two set off on a path to revenge. And so hopefully, this Hammond can answer all the questions we have. But let's see if, in fact, he's even going to be responsive. Oh, the other thing is, we invested in some of our skills here, but now that I kind of have a weird scenario set up. So, we've got the two levels of Axie and the Exploding Quen. We also have the other Quen sign here. I think maybe instead of the 14 attack power, if I take like a greater blue here. Yeah, there we go. Then we can get the 20 for sign intensity. Just a bigger overall increase. Whoa, Roach. Okay, that's pretty direct path.
Whoa!
You know what? What is up here? This looks kind of interesting. Stairway to nowhere, perhaps? No, there's a stairway to something. So? What is this?
I've not seen you here before. What do they call you?
Geralt of Rivia.
I'm Yuta Undimmon. No man's been found who could best me in combat.
Oh, no. I mean,
will you fight me?
You? I've defeated Pharaoh's most famous warriors. Men so worthy of respect, I don't dare mention their names. And who is Geralt of Rivia?
Guess you'll
Someone
have to find
you
out.
Defeated.
Maybe you're not worthy of my time. You performed any great feats? Because I don't believe I've heard.
What kind of feats you have in mind?
If I'm to fight a witcher, I could use a fitting sword. At the sea's bottom, not far from the shore, lies the wreck of Horned Hoskell's longship. And amidst the wreck lies Hoskell's sword, which legend claims cannot be chipped. Bring it to me, and I'll fight you.
Good. I'll give it a shot. See you soon.
I truly wonder if you will. Farewell.
I'm pretty sure she just manipulated us big time. Big time. These guys are not happy with each other. I'm gonna try this. Oh no, oh no no. Oh, that was lucky. It's not too far away. I'm curious about this sword because there might be a way that we can keep it, maybe if we beat her.
Come on.
Come on, Roach, let's move somewhere. All right, let's ride.
Friends, we show heart.
Drink last night, too?
Best blade's not worth shite if a weak arm is swinging.
Watch it!
He's all in control here. Not us.
His face could use a switch.
Don't cross our paths.
Alright. This is better. Also, I really want to try the puppet thing. See how that works. Look for the sword Judah requested at the sunken ship's wreck using your Witcher senses. You know what, Roach? I'm just gonna take this from here. Thanks. You go rest for a bit. Oh yeah. Get a little hybrid oil going, shall we? They don't seem to... Oh, there we go. How's this? Is it working? Oh yeah, I think we got one. There we go. That's cool.
Come on, come closer.
There we go. See, now it didn't... Okay, that's weird. Just stunned him. And same thing. Okay, that seems strange. Maybe because I have both equipped or something, like... God, will one of you just land? They're gonna best me if we're in the water. That's for sure. There we go. See, I can stun him, but I can't, the puppet's not working for some reason. That's weird. Let's try our Quen here. Let's go. Feel free. Maybe they know my tricks. Very patient of you. I kind of want to just see how much damage we can absorb. Okay, so it seems like it's probably related to how much damage they're dishing out. If I grab all of this. There it is. And Huskald's sword. I don't think we're gonna find anything worthwhile here, but you never know. Come on. Oh, of course. There we go. Okay. Now when we can, we should take a second here. There we go. One thing maybe we could try is, what if we remove this one, the regular one, just to see if that's maybe what's causing it. Put the Quen there. Let's remove this one. And then up here, we can just throw back the arrows. And we'll drop in a red mutagen here. Just to see if that's what's causing it.
What now, you piece of filth?
Yeah, see, there we go. Because it has no choice but to go that route. That's weird. Alright, I'm gonna let them battle it out. Unless I'm doing something strange, but... that seems to be the only thing that's really working for me. Oh, really? Yeah, that's not good. Hit me. Oh, let's go. This is cool. Oh, that's bad. That's bad. I know you want to. Yeah, see, we gain a lot of health back. Cyclops is cool. We ran into one earlier, but it was way too strong. This one, however, not so bad. I don't know if these things are gonna come down and fight us, to be honest. What was he protecting? Greater Marana Runestone? Hello. Mahakaman Heavy Armor. Okay, not bad. 5% chance to poison is great, though. Okay. What do we have in terms of regular runestones? We have a Glyph of Quen, which isn't bad. We don't have any greaters, I don't think. A bunch of lessers. Which I could then maybe craft into greater ones, but let's go ahead and use this at least. Cyclops Eye. Sure, that'll come in handy. We're actually getting a bit low on regular crossbow bolts, but I know we have some specialty types. Come on, Roach. Just keep up. Tell you what, I'll race you there. Whoa, that dude has got some special things happening. What does this guy need? This is a pretty busy place, actually.
What's the matter?
Maybe Trold and my brothers, Mikael and Ulf, sailed to Hindersfjall to fetch Agder, wedding Zin but a few days, but they've yet to return.
Uh-oh.
A storm broke while they were gone. I fear it might have blown them onto the rocks at Faroe. Many have lost their lives there.
And say we're heading to Faroe, aren't we?
I would, but I've got to make sure the wedding's proper prepared. They say it's not fitting for a Skelliger to ask for aid, but I've no choice. Will you help me? Will you seek out my kin?
He seems trustworthy enough.
Fine. I'll look around for them.
Okay. Now, in terms of Juta here, let's see the sword. 40 armor piercing and critical hit chance, but no actual damage that we can see. We're gonna have to give it to her anyway, so I doubt it's something that we're gonna be able to really use. Maybe afterwards, we'll see.
Go, go.
Now, I don't know if this is quote-unquote fair for her, but we're gonna use our hangman's venom. Oh, so you have heard some stories.
Greetings, White One.
Got Huskold's sword like you wanted. Have yet to check if it really can't be chipped.
Well, well. How did you manage it?
Didn't take much. Just a bit of holding my breath and swinging my arms and legs at the same time.
Strong in the mouth. Let's see if you're as cocky in the ring.
Okay, let's do it.
Ready when you are.
Then let's start. May Freya choose the victor.
I prefer to rely on my own senses. Oh, okay. So we can use signs. That's good.
Come on.
Yeah, I don't think she really stands much of a chance, to be fair. She's literally on fire.
Enough! Enough! Oh, gods!
Not surprised you have a hard time finding worthy opponents.
In the end, one came along. Where'd you learn all that?
It's a bit of a long story, but have you ever heard of Kaer Morhen?
At Kaer Morhen.
Kaer Morhen?
Oh, she does know where it is.
But you learned a great deal on the road as well, surely. Would you tell me about it?
It'd make for a long story.
All right. We need a quiet spot, some good mead, and what do you say?
Yeah, sure.
Gladly. See you at the inn?
Too rowdy. Come to my home in Harviken.
Well,
I'll be waiting after dusk.
See you later then.
Just after we confess our undying love to Yennefer. This is kind of their relationship though, right? I mean, well, this'll work. I think Yennefer and I, we kind of have like a don't ask, don't tell policy.
Can you toss an axe?
I definitely am not going to ask, and I'm definitely not going to tell. Now, it has to be after dusk, so let's go to a nice romantic time, like 8 p.m. Maybe she really does just want to hear my stories.
You're a witcher, right?
Well, yeah, haven't we discussed this?
Greetings.
I started to think you'd changed your mind.
I'd never miss a chance to spend a pleasant evening with you.
I don't know that I'll make for engaging company. In truth, I rarely talk to men.
Why rarely?
Rarely? Why?
Well, I don't like to waste time chatting before fights. And after them, I've none left to talk to.
It's fair.
And now that I've finally met someone stronger, it seems Freya's played a cruel trick on me.
What's Freya got to do with it?
I swore to the goddess that only he who bested me in battle would lie with me, take me as his wife, and give me children.
She knows that we're not capable of that.
Can't really help you with the second and the third. But I'm sure I could think of something to satisfy the first.
We've got that look
exactly
in our eye.
Exactly what I'd hoped for.
Not gonna lie, that weighs on my conscience a bit. I know it probably shouldn't, but... What about all of our clothes? Are you serious? Well, it was nice doing, battle with you, I suppose. Okay, let's go back to what we were doing before. Here. Going for Hammond. Small detour.
Drink last night too. Hot zippers.
Hey.
Let's go, Roach. Oh, look at this. Another Cyclops. Did we... Here, let's take a look here. Cyclopses. How about this? We take a big stake, sharpen its tip, jam it in the Cyclops' eye, then sneak out of the cave disguised as sheep. How's that not a good idea? Otis Thaka Traveler. Died tragically on Speakroog, yeah. Cyclopses can easily be recognized by the single eye located in the center of their foreheads. If for some reason that is not visible, other telltale signs of their enormous size, incredible strength, and a seething hatred for all humans. Vulnerable against Axie and Quinn. Okay, well. And, since we know it's an Ogroid, where is it? Here we go. I actually really like trapping that one in the Quen sign as well. There we go. Let's get behind him. There we go. Woo-hoo! Wow. I think I said I like trapping him in the Quen sign. What I really meant was obviously the Urden sign.
Run, Roach.
And he's still on fire. Okay, Hammond, where are you? What do we have going on here?
The gods will punish you.
I have a feeling I know how this is going down.
Through. No sweat off your back, no harm done.
Perhaps, but then tain't no help to us neither. Besides, why do you care? You as nanny or something?
Yeah, something like that. Just let the guy pray.
No, I'm someone who has weapons and knows how to use them.
Hear that, lads? He's threatening us.
Let's see if his swords are as sharp as his tongue.
Oh, they are. Hello. Man, that's actually really difficult to get off. You need a lot of distance. There we go. So is he with me now? Or is he just stunned? I'm mostly just trying to experiment with this and get a handle for how it works. There, fight your boys. And we got harpies.
We'll fix you soon, don't
Thank you, Wanderer. I shall say a prayer for you at my pilgrimage's end.
Nice gesture, thanks. Now, where's your pilgrimage taking you?
To the four faces of Hemdal, raised in honor of our great hero.
Can you tell me about Hemdal?
I've heard the legends of Hemdal, a great warrior and first father of the Isles.
His tree. And before the advent of Ted Dare, the final age, he shall return, walk amidst us, and face the evil powers, demons, and specters of chaos.
This sounds familiar.
Cockerel Camby will crow to warn Hemdal of the coming of the Nargle Fair, bringing the army of darkness. A battle will ensue, Ragnarok, and Hemdal will clash with the forces of the dark.
Let's hope he wins.
It'll make no difference. The prophecy is clear. After Ragnarok, the world will end.
Prophecies can be tricky that way, and there's never an ending that's not also a new beginning, a fresh start.
Let us hope you're right, Wanderer. Let us hope you're right.
Okay. I don't feel too bad about helping him out. Those guys were just... I mean, let's call them what they were. Let's just imagine we're calling them what they were. Okay, to Hammond. There's a lot of action on the way to Hammond. So it looks like Hammond's going to be in the general vicinity here. Trotheim.
Whoa.
Trotheim?
What do you want?
I'm looking for Hammond.
What for?
Business.
He prays at the chapel on the hill this time of day. If it's slaves you're looking to buy, you'll have to wait till he's done.
I don't need any slaves, actually.
He's praying. Wouldn't have thought him a God-fearing man from what I've heard about him.
Yet it's not something that would surprise any man who knows him.
Another snoop. You know the drill.
Oh, are you shitting me?
You're the sorceress.
Keep together!
My god. I don't know if this puppet thing is the best thing for us. Oh yeah, he's doing work now though, when you can get it to work.
Ah!
Roach, thanks for getting involved, but now's not the best time.
Come on, closer.
Here comes another. I guess because of the fact that I asked if he was a God-fearing man, it kind of shows, well, you don't know who he is, so he must not be here for the right reasons. Orders from Hammond and orders from Hammond. Okay, let's see what he's ordering these guys to do. Next time I gotta make sure to visit the shrine on the hill and make an offering before setting out. The god's favor, that's what matters most. So if any customers come, tell them to wait till I get back. They'll understand. They know I'm liable to get ornery when someone interrupts my prayers. Keep your eyes peeled. Come on. Wouldn't be bad getting one of these guys controlled, honestly. Like one of the archers. Jesus.
Come on.
And we can take these guys out relatively easily. It's just I'm really trying to get the hang of the of the Axie.
Let's end this.
Give him hell.
Alright, the old-fashioned way seems to be working, so let's just stick with that.
You know who you trust?
I think so. I've yet to see one of these new finishing moves that we've learned. There we go. Oh, he went down in one hit. All of those orders are the same that we've seen. Indrigas? Oh, look, I think I see where the... You know what, we haven't fought Indrigas for a while. Where's our insectoid oil? There it is.
Come on.
Look, the path is just littered with them.
Gods of the sea, I've never begrudged you no gifts. Grant me another victory, so I can make you another offering of me loot.
Don't mind me.
Fuck, what now?
You were in Carradine's band, weren't you?
Heard you were in Carradine's band.
Fucking say what you want. Come on, spit it out, you arse-licking bastard.
Jeez, right after prayers?
I'm looking for Yad Carradine.
But just who the hell are you?
A friend of a friend. I'm looking for Carradine. Thought maybe we could make some sort of deal.
What? Our business robbing some Novigrad pricks the wrong way? Plowing guilds. Come on, what are you waiting for? Kill the fucker!
Okay. That's what it's gonna be. We got somebody in there doing our dirty work. Okay, letter written on elegant stationery. That must be his diary. Meet Lambert at the Nowhere Inn. Okay. We have a whole bunch of weapons here that we could get rid of. We've been picking up pretty much everything, but let's see this letter. Hammond, I thought I made it clear during our last face-to-face talk. I don't want to keep in touch with you, and I especially don't want to do any business with you. I've no doubt the enterprise you propose would be profitable. Nevertheless, to speak colloquially? Colloquially, count me out. There are plenty of other potential buyers in Novigrad. Goldsmith, jewelers, merchants dealing in luxury goods for starters. I don't need to get involved. Whatever you decide, I wish you well in it. Treat this letter as our final farewell, Carradine. Okay. Now, I thought that Lambert was back in Kaer Morhen. Guess not. And not only is he not in Kaer Morhen, he's like very close nearby. I don't know if very close nearby actually makes sense grammatically, but... What's the price of honor all of a sudden? Search the shore using your... Whoa, what tipped us off on that? Yeah, sirens? Okay, fair enough. What is it that they were...
Blue and bloated. Didn't seem to bother the sirens, though. Must have nabbed her body soon after she drowned. Kira's lamp ought to prove really handy here.
Oh, wow, that's throwback. Okay, so...
Merciful friend, forgive your son. Meant to escort our brother's betrothed to her wedding, a storm beset us and bested us. All is lost. Agda lies dead. Her dowry drowned. 'Tis a taint on the clan's honor. Forgive us, O Freya, most noble.
Stop, Mikael. Freya can't wash our shame away. Only blood can. Let's do it as it must be done. There, beneath the tree. We'll pray, and then end it.
Oh.
You're right. Be better that way.
Okay.
Footprints. Wonder where they lead.
Probably towards that giant, what sounds like an Indriga. Roach, you just stay there for a second. Here's the tree.
Skellige Honor chose to die instead of living with the knowledge they'd let down their brother.
Letter from Agda's father to Timon, a chess key. Tell the young man what happened to his betrothed and his brothers. Okay, that's the guy that we just recently talked to, I believe. In the Clan Dimmen village, spied a feverish man who was waiting for his brothers to bring his betrothed back from one of the neighboring isles. Days had passed, the wedding drew near. Yeah, it's the same guy. And neither brothers nor the betrothed had arrived. So we just happened to come along the shore where that took place. That's not going to be a happy ending.
Move it!
Okay, the Nowhere Inn is not... Let's see. Okay, so that's back in Novigrad. Let's go in through the Oxenfurt Gate.
Ciri led Geralt to conclude that Uma, the ugliest man alive and the victim of a curse, was the key to finding...
But even still, I thought that he was at Kaer Morhen for some reason.
Where's Eustace? It was him always ordered the corpses.
Aye, he did.
Oh!
Damage!
I hope you go.
Excuse me, everyone. That's right, I remember the name of this place too, and now I feel bad for not realizing that it wasn't even on the same continent. Okay, Lambert.
What the hell took you?
Pretty likely Carradine lives in Novigrad. And he never severed ties with Hammond. They're actually in business together.
Learned something too. He trades in, live goods on the sly.
Yeah, we've
owns
heard.
A ship called the Pearl of the Coast. Runs between here and Skellige. Changed his name, too. To Roland Truger, who officially is a respected Novigrad trader and philanthropist.
Huh.
Has a residence in Gildorf.
Anything on Selyse?
Well, didn't have you there to stand up for her.
Okay, well, should we go see the guy?
All right, let's pay Carradine a visit.
Think I know how to get in. I got a plan.
If your plan doesn't include dealing with an escort of guardsmen, best revise it. Calm now. Let them start it.
You're expected. Come in.
Oh?
Make yourselves
hello.
At home.
He's a witcher.
Very true. Allow me to introduce my wife, Letitia, and my two little tots. You know who I am, and I've heard of you. You've been asking many questions about me. That always draws my attention.
What school do you come out of?
That of the cat. So few of us left.
So we've noticed.
I could understand a witcher becoming a hired assassin, but a merchant?
Why ever not? Not one among us doesn't dream of changing our life. I simply did not stop at dreaming. They say no witcher has ever died in his bed. I aim to be the first.
Remains to be seen.
And these kids, they can't truly be yours.
Witchers can't have children.
But they can have wards, or take in a woman
right.
along with her children, embrace them as their own.
That we're more familiar with.
My friend needs to talk to you.
Lads, take the children and Letitia and leave us. Our guests wish to speak to me. I'm all ears.
Talk to him, Geralt. If I do, first word he says to me, I'll lose it and throttle the fucker.
Does your wife know everything about your past?
Your wife know who you were?
We are thoroughly honest with one another, harbor no secrets. She prays for me each day. You know what? I think it's working.
Fucking hell.
Relax, Lambert.
I confessed all just before we pledged to marry one another. Began a new life that day, with a clean slate.
Nice place you got.
As it turned out, I've a flair for enterprise. Now I've coin enough to provide my family with the finer things in life.
With some left over for philanthropy.
Miss Marabella's Institute does not scorn small donations. Neither does the city's Widows and Orphans Relief Fund, amongst others.
You don't have to remember a witcher named Aiden.
Remember Aiden? A witcher. Murdered in Elander. Guessing the killers were paid well.
Had to come into the coin somehow.
I remember him as I remember all the others, with the deepest regret. Yet Aiden was different in a way. Contrary to rumor, we did not set out to kill him. We were forced to when he attacked us.
So, just what happened?
What's your version of this story?
Aiden had accepted a contract to lift the curse from the Duke's daughter. He took the coin, bungled the job, then left once the girl passed on.
You lie.
We were not to kill him. We were debt collectors. He'd spent the coin already, so we demanded his swords. When he refused, tempers flared. Vienne, positioned as a sniper, lost her nerve. Hit Aiden square in the eye. Later, she devised her own version of the story. To silence her guilt, I expect.
I've heard enough.
What now?
Oh. So, this is tough. How do we know? I don't think we have a clear-cut answer here. And, like, I'm thinking about Aiden, or Lambert here, and obviously he's got strong... feelings about this situation. He said he was just gonna, like, kill the guy outright, which is probably kind of not the best idea. So, I'm not sure what we should be doing. If we say he's changed, then he kind of gets off scot-free, right? If we say his remorse is fake, then we're probably going to have to fight him and kill him, but he's got a wife and kids to look out for. If we say it's too late to repent, probably the same thing. If we say we'll leave him alone, then that's kind of a tough scenario as well, right? So, I'm not sure what we should do. I think we leave him alone. And if we don't have clear evidence, I don't think it's something we should step in on.
We need to leave him alone, Lambert. Come on.
I'm not going anywhere. I came to kill this bastard.
Yeah, I know you did.
Leave him. Let's go.
You off your fucking nut?
Lambert, this is one of those situations when you have to realize you're pissed as hell, rein it in, and trust your cool-headed friend. Let's go.
For fuck's sake, Geralt. Don't know that I'll be able to forgive you.
I said let's go. You can always come back.
There we go. Don't make me regret this.
Explain yourself.
Don't intend to. Just felt Carradine didn't deserve to be murdered in cold blood. If you feel otherwise, you can always go back. Without me.
I feel like beating the shit out of you. See you later. Someday.
So long, Lambert. Can we talk?
What about?
Well, you haven't changed a bit.
You haven't changed a lick.
That disappointment I hear?
No. Surprise, maybe. Most grow gentler with age. Seems you're growing pricklier.
Mom always said I was different.
Had some other adjectives in mind, but different'll do. Nice to be together again, wouldn't you say?
Mm-hmm. Just missing Ciri.
Thanks for reminding me.
I had to change the subject. Heard a sentimental sob making its way up from your gut. Any idea why she's returned?
Shortest version, she's running from the Wild Hunt.
Damn. Going gets tough and you need help, you can count on me.
Well, since I have you here...
Ever play Gwent?
Of course. Even tried to teach Vesemir, but turned out he's just mule-headed. Why do you ask? Up for a quick hand?
Yeah, let's do it.
Am I? Have you crying like a baby by the time I'm through with you?
Knowing Lambert, that's probably true as well. Okay. So, Northern Realms deck, here we come. He's got Scoia'tael deck. Let's see how dirty he plays. Couple of decoys aren't bad. Got the Spy as well. A Scorch, Blue Stripe. Catapult, Geralt, Vernon. Not a bad draw. Oh, we switch a blue stripe for a blue stripe. And Dandelion. Yeah, I should probably get rid of this Dandelion, to be honest, but we'll see how it plays out here. Let's throw down our Stennis. Yeah, see, the Commander's Horns are so much more flexible, and really, he doesn't add anything except for the fact that I can play him on the front line, and it gives a tiny buff. I don't even think it buffs him, so... I'm hoping he plays that Spy card and I can get that back. And we don't have a lot of cards outside of our special guys that are up front anyways, so... Yeah, here he comes. Oh, beautiful. Well, what I could do is I could just take the round with, like, a trebuchet here. And then I could play the Stennis card next round. Gives him 5 damage, but really, that's not the end of the world. beautiful. Okay, here they come. I mean, there's not gonna be a better time where I can get rid of three cards, really. I'm gonna do it. Now it's just mano a mano. I think we could probably take him. Let's see, what do we have in here? We've got Dandelion that we could bring back if we get anybody on the front line, but we don't really have that going for us. So let's just start laying it down. Triss, oh cool. I don't think we've ever seen her. Biting Frost, I'm okay with that. Yennefer, okay. What's he gonna bring back, I wonder? Ah, the spy. I like it, okay. Not bad. That's really hurting him now. That Frost. By really, I mean, like, not a lot, but a little bit. Now remember, we can always clear the weather. Okay, he used a Scorch card, that's fine. I'm just trying to piece together what he might have that could beat us, and I just don't see it happening. That's a cool card. Who's this? Isengrin Foliatiarna? It's like I've lost all my speech capabilities. Another Scorch, that's fine by me. Hurts us both equally, so truthfully it hurts him more. Siri card, beautiful. See that he was saving that one. It's enough Scorches already. Well, we are gonna take this one. What I could have done for more damage is brought out the catapults there, but it's all good. Good game, Lambert. Good game.
You win. Oh, can't believe I gotta give up my unique card. Better your hands than someone else's, I guess.
Agreed. Thank you very much. So, what does he have for us? Oh, it's a Triss! Beautiful. Throw Triss in there. I'm gonna get rid of Dandelion. Like, our deck's pretty fantastic now, I would say. Okay, well, I think we're gonna take a break here. We'll definitely head back to Skellige.
I need a belt set with silver studs.
Just a small letter for the next winter.
Can I hear market
news? You can also solve mysterious murders happened in some house.
You're here with the set.
The imagination of a drunk chief.
Okay, so thank you everybody for watching. We'll see you soon. I'm gonna head back to Skellige and go from there and see what other kind of trouble we can get into. What island do I want to go to? We could go down to Holmstein's Port. We can maybe go look for that giant on Unvik. Could go out to Svorlog there. Eurelia Harbor has a lot going on. And then there's all these like different caches in the water, which isn't that exciting, but... Let's actually see. Let's do a quick review of Swords and Dumplings. Gather Sucrose. Oh, you know what? Maybe we should do that while we're here. Maybe we should do that. We could do some of the fights. We could do a couple of these things. Black Pearl maybe is where we should head next. Get the blacksmith's tools from Unvik. And on Unvik, we have the Lord of Unvik. Ask around the Newport Inn about the ice giant. Maybe that's what we do. Okay, so down here by the Marlin coast, let's do it. We'll see you guys soon. Thanks again. Bye.
The Duma, the ugliest man alive and the victim of a curse, was the key to finding the young woman.